We've seen great things from TMS Web, how easy it is to build forms. However, what we've never shown you before in a video is how to persist values. Whenever I restart my application, the form looks like it has been designed. So it would be neat if there was an easy way to persist values the user entered, and when the application is opened the next time, these values reappear. Be aware, of course, that these values are bound to a session or to the web browser. Because on the web, we have basically options of cookies to store it in a session, and this is the new thing I had to get used to as well, the so-called local storage. Local storage is kind of like a tiny database that you can use to store values. This is the TMS web application you just saw in the designer. This is a memo. And if you open the application window or the application debug window, whatever you want to call it, using F12 in Google Chrome, you can see the HTML. And what you can see is, and this is something I had to look for myself, there is something called the application tab. And on the application tab, you find local storage and session storage. And if you go to local storage, you see that your application here doesn't have any storage. And the way it works is you assign value to a key. And that is exactly what TMS Web offers. TMS Web offers the weblib storage unit. And there you have two classes, tLocalStorage and tSessionStorage. And both of these classes allow you to set values and get values using a key. So getting back to the initial example, we want to be able to store values that have been set by the user, and we want to restore them when the application is started. So let's persist the values first when the user leaves the memo. And as this is Delphi, we can simply use the exit event of the component. So we go to the object inspector, select web memo 1, go to the events, and on exit. And what we have to do here is pretty straightforward. We declare a variable for the local storage, call it lstorage, and it will be of type tLocalStorage. And we simply have to create an instance of that. So lstorage tLocalStorage.create. And all we have to do in order to store the values of a memo field in this database is we call the lStorage.setValue method. And the key we're going to use is fixed. I'm going to call it memo. And the value of the memo is our component. We haven't named that component so far. To make it a little bit readable, I'm going to rename it from web memo to memo. Here we go, memo.lines.text. So this is all the text that's inside of the memo. And finally, I love Delphi because it says really finally in the language itself, we need to free the object. I'll storage free. So this will take care of storing the values inside of the local storage. In order to load the values, we have to do the same thing, but of course we have to pick a different event. And the event that we are going to use is going to be the form on show event. And then we're going to do the same thing all over again. We're going to define a variable for our local storage. We're going to create an instance of tLocalStorage. And instead of setting the value, we're now going to read the value into the memo. So memo.lines.text equals what we read, lStorage.getValue. And the key was memo. And finally, lStorage.free. Perfect. That's all it takes. So this is the example again. This is a example. We left the components, so this should be in the local storage already. And here you see local storage, our application memo is set to this is a example, which is bad English. This is an example. And if we go into the component and exit the component, you see that the local storage is updated. Finally, let's check if it works when we restart the application. We quit the browser. We start the application again. And dragging the browser window into the recording area, here we see this is an example. The value is being restored. So this video has shown you how easy it is to store values in local storage.